Ladies and gentlemen, Erik can't say.
Thank you. Thank you. You're always too kind. Okay. Today, I'm going to be talking to you about mental health in America. Imagine not being able to spend time with your own child just because your brain physically won't let you. You can't get out of bed, not from a lack of energy, but from the lack of a will to do anything at all. Everyday people struggle with even mundane mental illnesses like depression and anxiety. It can be very hard for these people to actually find help with these issues. Most people are written off as crazy, whiny, or just sad people who need to settle down. These people struggle again and again because their physical brains are different and they need help. 8 million people die every year due to mental illness, whether it be suicide or even these people harming others. Studies show that the number one factor in regards to suicide is mental illness and mental stability. While some people out there are insane, these are the people you can help. The ones with crippling anxiety attacks that cause them to spiral, or the people with depression that can't see the point in anything. Everyone likes to focus on the homicides caused by schizophrenia, but not the ADHD kid who generally tries but just can't focus and sit down. Imagine a world where those people would still exist. They could talk about their problems and not be ostracized or embarrassed to ask for help and get the medication they seriously need to help them. Where afflicted parents could have fun and play with their children, or the kid with dyslexia could become a doctor that saves lives, or the cop with clinical anxiety could not freeze up and help countless people. Mental illness could go from a mountain to climb to a hurdle to jump. There's already plenty of organizations like the National Association for Mental Illness, the Mental Health Association in Delaware, and others who try to help as many people as possible for completely free. There are websites that allow you to find help near you and even share your stories like Here to Help. There are people out there who want to help you. I need you to donate if possible. I need you to take the time to research these topics on your own. And most of all, undoubtedly, if you notice any signs of mental illness with someone you barely even know, or even someone you hate, please muster the strength to talk to them. Ask them, advise them, and help them. The smallest nudge might get someone the help they seriously need, even if indirectly. Thank you.